Purple Onion is delighted to present our young men of melody, the music, and the profound nonsense of the Smothers Brothers. Let's say hello.
We'd like all for all of you tonight to join in with us and sing along with our new album, Sing Along with Smothers.
What's it similar to?
Similar to the album on Columbia Records. This is Mercury Records, but similar to the record on Columbia made by Mitch Mel. Sing Along with Bitch.
Mitch.
Oh, we are marching to Pretoria, Pretoria, Pretoria. Oh, we are marching to Pretoria, Pretoria today. Hey, we are marching to Pretoria, Pretoria, Pretoria. Oh, we are marching to Pretoria, Pretoria today.
Brother Dickie Smutter.
Well, sing with me and I'll sing with you. And we will sing together, and we will dance together, and we will sing together. Well, sing with me and I'll sing with you. We will dance and sing together as we march along.
Oh, we are marching to Pretoria, Pretoria, Pretoria. Oh, we are marching to Pretoria, Pretoria today.
Brother Tom.
I'd like to clarify this just a little bit before we go any further. This is not Peoria, and a lot of you probably thought that we started out that this was Peoria, and it's not Peoria. A lot of people thought that there was Peoria, probably.
Yeah, somehow.
Probably thought that, maybe. This is, see, all the marching songs are done in foreign countries, and all the marching songs are done in foreign countries, and Peoria is not in a foreign country. It's a capital city of Nebraska.
No.
All the marching songs are done in foreign countries, like the March the River Kwai was a marching song from a foreign country. Sold over 7 million records here in the United States. It sold over 7 million records here in the United States, and it was hit rate for 35 weeks. And it was the March the River Kwai from the movie, The March the River Kwai. You remember, March the River Kwai. It sold over 7 million records, and not once during this entire time is the number one song in the United States of America for 35 weeks, The March of the River Kwai. Not once did they sing the words to it.
The words?
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
They whistled the words. They just whistled the words, and in the movie, The March of the River Kwai, they're marching through the mud and the gravel and the stuff in the river, and they're... They're whistling the words, and Peggy Lee, matter of fact, Peggy Lee recorded and sold over 250 records.
And
she just whistled the words. Yeah. The words were dirty.
All right, you just sing. Go ahead and sing.
Well, my foot's tapping, my guitar's ringing, dingin', 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 dingin'. You sleep with me, I'll sleep with you, so we will march together. So we will march
together.
March on, we'll sing together. You sleep with me, I'll sleep with you.
Marching, 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 oh, marching to Pretoria.
Pretoria,
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 oh, we are marching.
Oh, we are skipping to
Pretoria. Pretoria, today.
Is there someone over there on the microphone over there, the house mic?
Is it loud? Maybe
I would like a little louder. Like,
is it loud? Is it loud enough?
Okay. I don't know if the mic's... Is someone... Tasting. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tasting.
Testing.
Tasting. 1, 2, little... Tasting. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tasting. That's a little joke. When the original 13 colonies were first founded in America, When our forefathers came over in the small wooden ships to sail across a vast, uncharted, storm-tossed ocean. To flee from religious prosecution to carve out a new nation. They came over in the small ships, the now famous ships, the Sunflower and the Pan Maria. And landed on the coast of California and formed...
Plymouth Rock.
On the eastern coast to form the original...
Thank you.
To form the original colonies. These forefathers of ours were the hardy forefathers, men and women, who were unsatisfied with just staying in one place.
Well,
they had were men of vision.
Some of them were satisfied.
Some of them were satisfied. Some of them were. But most of them had great vision as through cursing. Through the pioneer blood cursing through their veins, they carved out of this new nation. And looked unsatisfied with vision, they looked westward. Like that. And packed up in their wagons, the great westward movement, they packed up their families, their children, and their and chairs and spoons. And moved in their westward wagons over the Apple Chain Mountains into the vast air of the plains. Great men have been eulogized in this westward movement, the great heroes of American westward movement. For example, the great men who built the railways in America we've all heard about. The great man, the great steel driving man, for example, has been eulogized in folk songs.
The steel driving man
that beat the steam drill in the mortal race. The great John Hank, the great steel driving man.
That was Henry Hank,
the great steel driving man. We'd like to do a song for you at this time about the men who worked the transportation up the vast riverways of America. The great hardy boatmen who worked the vast riverways up down in America. They worked these big flatboats with hundreds of pounds of cargo piled up on these big flatboats. They stood on the back with poles and worked their boats up and down with poles in the vast riverways. The great boatmen of America. With poles. And they wander... roll their boats, but they shim poles every morning when they want to roll their boats. They come to work 7 days a week, 6:30 every single morning, and they come into the boathouse every morning and they want to roll their boats, and they come in 6:30 every morning, and the captain would say, "Hi there." "Hi, Captain. I roll my boat today." "No, you can't." So you could see the hard life they lived, because sometimes the water in the river was over 270 feet deep.
Pretty deep.
The poles are short. Bob Bowman are lost this way. And Dance Bowman Nance tells us the only happiness in their drab river lives, it probably tells their Saturday night in town when these boatmen take their meagers, after work, take their meagers week's penances. Their meagers week's penance.
No, that's not right.
Money.
Money.
Uyghurs makes
no.
Lousy wages. It probably tells their Saturday night in town when these boatmen go into town and pick up their oars.
Oh, that's
not the same.
Boatmen dance, boatmen sing, boatmen do most anything. Dance, boatmen dance, dance, boatmen dance. Dance all night to the broad daylight, go home with the gals in the morning. Hey-ho, boatmen roll, sail down the river on the Ohio. Hey-ho, boatmen roll, sail down the river on the Ohio. Boatmen sing, boatmen dance, boatmen loves Miss Marianne. Dance, boatmen dance, dance, boatmen dance. Dance,
excuse me. Thanks a lot.
I'm a boatman, gee, I'm sore. I came home without an oar.
Dance, boatmen dance, boatmen dance. Dance all night to the broad daylight, go home with the gals in the morning. Hey-ho, boatmen row, sail down the river on the Ohio. Hey-ho, boatmen row, sail down the river on the Ohio. This old boatman went ashore, liked it so he stayed for more. Dance, boatmen dance, dance, boatmen dance.
This, well,
come
now.
On. Hurry up.
This old boatman went to shore, spent his money on a...
dance. Dance, pope, and dance. Dance all night to the broad daylight. Go home with the gals in the morning. Hey ho, pope and rose, sail on the river on the Ohio. Hey ho, pope and rose, sail on the river on the Ohio. Hey ho, pope and rose, sailing down the river on the Ohio.
I'd like to introduce the rest of the group at this time. We're the Smothers Brothers, and this is on my right is my younger brother who plays the bass and sings the tenor parts in the arrangement.
I'm over here.
You're over on my right. It's my younger brother who plays the bass and sings the pays attention in the back over there. It's my younger brother, Dickie Smothers, who plays the bass, and a lot of times people will ask us, they'll come up and say, "You're not really brothers, are you? You just say that because you're singing and you're not really brothers. You just, are you not actually really brothers, are you?" They ask us that. Mm. Also,
well, we are brothers. I know we're real brothers.
And in downstairs in the place downstairs, after show, a lady comes, she grabbed me and she said, you might be brothers, but your name isn't Smothers, is it? That's a funny name, and then you just made up that name to make it rhyme because you're boy siblings and you're singing and it's not really your name. Smothers is a stupid name. That's our real name, Smothers.
Down in the valley, the valley so low, hang your head over, hear the wind blow, hear the wind blow. Down in the
July every June 3rd. As you might know, they hold the exciting camel races to commemorate June 3rd, where hundreds and thousands of the Uruguayans go out annually every year on June 3rd to watch the best, exciting, moving camel races in excitement.
So one hump camels.
One hump camel races in excitement. You'll probably be caught up in the excitement, probably. Maybe.
Zenut, 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 Habanetoina, Hyalina. Alna, 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 Tikna Bena, Mi Ben Haile Lishtaval. Zen, Zen, Nut, Zen, 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 Nut, Havanetta, Rena, Haile Lingba Mosha.
Join us as we go back to the years, back to 1920, where the flapper era and prohibition, and no drinking, and the excitement of the happiness of the roaring 20s. Fly with us in your imagination.
That's where the folk songs were written.
SOS, SOS, Captain, we are lost. Our ship is floundering in the sea by wind and rain. We're tossed. Lifeboats here, lifeboats there, hear the shrieks and groans. The captain shouts, all hands on deck, and hear a mournful moan. Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria, tonight. Oh, how I miss those gals in Peoria, Peoria, tonight.
Why did I ever roam with sailor boys? I should have stayed back home in Illinois.
Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria, tonight. On the freeways we must drive, much to our chagrin, in our tiny foreign car, so small and made of tin. Other cars go speeding past so fast that they could fly. Just before the dreadful crash, you'll hear this mournful cry. Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria, tonight. Oh, how I miss those gals in Peoria, Peoria, tonight. Why, you can pick those morning glorias right off the sidewalks of Peoria. Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria, tonight.
We like to change the pace again from the high point of excitement, like. We like
out.
To do a ballad at this time. A ballad entitled Maraicha.
What?
Maraicha. Maraicha is an Israeli folk song describing
Israeli,
the wind.
No, wait a minute. Israel is not Israeli.
It's an Israeli
it's
folk
Dutch.
Song.
It's Dutch. Tommy, Maraicha is Dutch. It's from Holland. It's an old Dutch folk song from Holland. They call the wind Mariah. It's from Holland.
It's an old Dutch folk song.
Right.
From the Israeli section of Holland.
Keep it up.
And it tells how important the wind plays in working the windmills in this section of Holland. And it's also a love story. And the fact that this young couple, very much in love, trip gaily up a grass-covered slope, hand in hand, to have a picnic underneath one of the windmills. And the sky was blue, and love shone out of their young eyes as they went and had their picnic underneath one of the windmills. And after the picnic was over, the young man went away and left his girl underneath the windmill. He just went away and left her underneath the windmill after the picnic was over. And then he came back later, and she got caught in the blades.
Oh, wait a minute. That's terrible.
She's all right now.
Fine.
Way out here they've got a name for rain and wind and fire.
The rain is Tess, the fire is Joe,
and they call the wind Mariah. Mariah blows the stars around and sets the clouds to flying.
Mariah makes the mountain sound like folks was up there dying. Mariah, Mariah, they call the wind Mariah.
Before I knew Mariah's name and heard her wail and whining, I had a gal and she had me, and the sun was always shining. Ah, ah, ah.
But then one day I left my gal, I left her far behind me.
And now I'm lost, so gathered lost, not even God can find me. Mariah, out here they've got a name for rain and fire only. But when you're lost and all alone, well, there ain't no name for lonely. Well, I'm a lost and lonely man without a star to guide me. Mariah, blow my love to me. I need my gal beside me. Mariah.
Like to do at this time a ballad about a very beautiful woman. This particular song was written by a man who was very much in love with this woman, as he wrote this next song as a monument and as a dedication towards her, because his love was very strong and he loved her very much, that it was very strong. They wrote this as a monument and as a dedication towards her, because she's so very beautiful and lovely, yet evil, wicked, mean, and bad, and nasty inside. And she used to go around shoving him and pushing him around and screaming at him and shoving at him and stuff. And he didn't care because she was so very beautiful and lovely. Had evil, wicked, mean, and bad, and nasty inside. She used to go around shoving him and pushing him around, and he just didn't care. And all the men that saw her just fell in love with her. There's just a bunch of men that didn't even know her, just standing around. She'd just walk down the street, and they'd see her, and they'd all fall in love with her.
I know, that's
just, they'd just be standing there, and she'd walk down the street, and they'd fall in love with her. She was a streetwalker. They didn't care, because she was so very beautiful and lovely, yet evil, wicked, mean, and bad, and nasty. And prosperous.
All right, that's enough.
Even during the Depression. So he didn't care. Seriously, though, a lot of times, I think in our own personal experiences and through reading books, novels, and movies, and even possibly people we know personally, we've seen great love affairs and great romances between a man and woman, and sometimes we've wondered to ourselves possibly that I don't understand why this guy loves her or she has so many faults, I don't understand, or vice versa. But the true loves, the mature love, in the world are built on the foundation that nobody's perfect and love is, that you adjust to the fact that nobody's perfect and love is very, and the foundation of beauty and strength for mature love is built on the nobody's perfect.
That's beautiful. That's good. Isn't that nice?
She was going around shoving him and pushing him around. And kicking him and stuff, and he knew she wasn't, she had a lot of faults. She was psychologically sick and with neurotic and psychosis, and he never once ever deserted her because his love was very strong, that he spent loving much money and loving care and devotion to this. Shut up. Spent much loving care.
About time.
I'll tell you when. As he never deserted her, as she was That's psychologically right. sick, and he sent her to all the world's great psychoceramists for help. She worked. She worked with Freud and Jung.
Right.
And her most notable success was with Pavlov. Every time he rang a bell, she was ready.
All right. Cut that out. That's enough.
She couldn't ride trains or trolley cars.
All right.
Ding, 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 ding.
Okay. Tell them the name of her.
You've probably heard her name before because her name is synonymous with beauty and evilness, and her name's been used for generations to note an evil wickedness, and it's synonymous with beauty and evilness, and so licentious name. Possibly you've heard this name before when someone in anger, unthinkingly and blatantly said this word in anger in reference to some woman. It's kind of a back alley word.
Nah,
it's
you
insidious.
Say it.
Nah, she was called Mary Ann Johnson. And the name of the song is entitled Mary Ann. Gee, you're mean and evil and wicked and bad and nasty and prosperous inside.
All right, fine.
Ooh, Jezebel, it was you, you, you. If ever the devil's plan was made to torment man, it was you. Jezebel, it was you. If ever a pair of eyes promised paradise, it was you. Jezebel, it was you. Like a demon, love possessed me. You obsessed me constantly. What evil star above was to shine above on your love?
Without
a pair of horns, it was you.
You're horny.
Just
pushing and shoving.
If ever a pair of eyes promised paradise, it was you. Jezebel, it was you. Like a demon, love possessed me. You obsessed me constantly. What evil star above was to shine above on your love? Jezebel.
Jezebel and Lolita.
Jezebel.
Betty Crocker.
Jezebel. Jezebel.
Some say that love is a gentle thing, but it only has caused me pain. For the only girl I ever did love, gone on that midnight train, I never will marry. I'll take me no wife. I expect to live single all of my life. The train pulled out and the whistle blew with a low and a lonesome moan. She's gone. me all alone. I never will marry. I'll take me no wife. I expect to live single all of my life. There's many a change in the winter wind, and the change in the cloud design. There's many a change in a young girl's heart, never a change in mine. I never will marry. I'll take me no wife. I expect to live single all of my life.
We'd like to do at this time a song that my brother wrote. This is original song my brother wrote 5 years ago. My brother wrote this song in a fit of creative passion and genius. My brother wrote this song, and we only performed it, my brother and myself, only 3 times. We performed this song 3 times, and it was immediately stolen from us by this other commercial crass. Was stolen from us by this other commercial crass group that stole the song. They never acknowledged.
No, Tommy, don't
they
go
just
into
stole
that.
The song
no.
from my younger
Tom,
brother.
Don't go into that. It's just embarrassing to say.
They're adults. They're entitled to know. They stole this song from
along
my brother,
with my luggage.
Along with his luggage. And they put it on one of the major record companies. They never once. And it sold over 3 million records, my brother's song that he wrote, and they never acknowledged it. As a result, it sold over 3 million records, and as a result, pay attention. As a result, every time we perform my own brother's song that he wrote in his creative effort and genius responsible, every time we perform this his own song, we've been ridiculed.
And persecuted.
We've been ridiculed and persecuted every time we perform this song, that people will come up and say, I heard your show, and you stole that song from that other commercial crass group. You just stole that song. So we're going to ridicule you, prosecute you.
Persecute
you. So I'd like to take this time to set the record straight, as my brother's depraved of the one...
You were right the first time.
He was depraved of this opportunity of having for posterity to understand and enjoy. He's been... I'd like to publicly dedicate the performance of this song to my younger brother for his creative effort and genius in writing this song.
You don't have to do that.
I'm going to, Dickie. Oh. I'd like to publicly dedicate to you, Dickie Smothers, the creative effort and genius responsible for this song. I'd like to publicly dedicate to you at this time.
Thanks.
Swell.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome. We'd like to perform it for you now, and I'm sure you've all heard the song many times before. But we'd like to do it for you in the original first time, the first time way
no,
in the
you
original.
You mean the
first
Virgin
time.
Edition?
The what?
I said, you mean the Virgin Edition. We'll sing it in the Virgin Edition.
I don't know what that means.
Oh, come on.
Edition, I don't know what it means.
Edition?
We'd like to do it to original Virgin.
No, just sing it.
Ready?
I'm ready.
I knew it'd be ridiculed.
Throughout history, there's been the story of the internal triangle. This
eternal
triangle. This
particular internal triangle concerned a condemned man named Tom Crudely, a man named Jason, and another man named Sally Jane Johnson.
Hey, now, cut that out.
Go hang down your head, Tom Crudely.
Poor boy.
Hang down your head and fly. Ha ha ha. Hang down your head, Tom Crudely. Poor boy, you're hung. I met her on a mountain.
Poor boy.
Oh, there I took her. Several times. I met her on a mountain. Stabbed her with my knife. Hang your head down. Hang your head down.
Do
hang down your head, Tom Crudely.
Poor boy.
Hang down your head and why? Hang down your head, Tom Crudely. Poor